What up, guys? Tough Thumbs here. Hope everyone had a good Christmas. I know I sort of did. I just haven't made many videos in the last couple days. I had a few crappy things happen. My girlfriend got sick and I had to take her to the hospital, so I spent the last couple days, like, you know, dealing with that. You know, she's okay, though. It was just some weird ear infection thing or something. And my sister gave birth to a baby boy, and I'm now officially an uncle, so that's pretty cool. But yeah, had a good Christmas, and I got a few cool things. I'm gonna show you the coolest thing. Like, my girlfriend got me a pair of boots, like some really kick-ass boots, basically for like all weather and everything. I've been looking for a good pair, and you know, she got me some really good ones. I'm not a boot reviewer though, so. But the coolest thing she got me was this bad boy right here. Simply the coolest freaking thing I have ever seen in my life. This is actually Dan Aykroyd's vodka, called Crystal Head Vodka. It's based off the whole Crystal Skulls thing. And it's pretty damn good. I don't like vodka, and I just like the bottle so much, that's why I wanted it. But the vodka is actually pretty damn good, just straight up, so. As you can see, I've been dipping into it a little bit. I'm not a big drinker, but, you know, it happens from time to time if it's sitting there in front of me. But this is just too freaking cool. And if you don't think this is cool, there's something wrong with you, seriously. That's just awesome. Anyway. Also, I got some Pimpage, but I got some new knives. I actually traded off the Warren Thomas for these two bad boys, Mike Snodies. Has a gift certificates, or not gift certificates, the certificates of authenticity. Poker chips, which is pretty sweet. And I like these things a lot, they're really cool. Came this nice Mike's, or Bill's case here. This one's a Boss. But apparently this one's one of a kind. It's got a flame colored edge. I listened to Between the Berry Man. It's got this cord wrap, red and black. A nice little lanyard ball there. But this thing's sweet. It's 154 cm, I believe. I'm not sure. It's like sandblasting the edges. Edge is ridiculously sharp. So that one's pretty sweet. This one, though, this one is, you know, this leather sheath here. This is the amazing Damascus. I guess it's like mirror. See that light reflecting on there? It's beautiful. And my favorite color, OD green with black. Just awesome. This one's a lot thicker. I think it's Chad Nichols Damascus, but. And Mike Snodie is a master knife maker. And this is my first time I've ever had any of his custom stuff, so I'm pretty excited about it. I am trying to sell one of them, I think. I don't need two, so, you know, PM me if you want one of them. I got them at a pretty decent price, but I know what this one's worth, so. Anyways, so on to the Pimpage of the evening. So, first up, the Warren Thomas actually going to Jeff in Canada. Really good dude. He's had a lot of work done here, had some issues with some stuff, but, you know, he sent me a lot of stuff, so some of the stuff, like one of the knives just wouldn't work out, but. In replacement, I'll be sending this back. I didn't send the Warren Thomas yet, dude, because I wanted to do this first and send it to you, so I wasn't sending a bunch of stuff to Canada, like, in the next few days. So, here it is, your Spyderco Persistence with the blue G10 Reptilian. Looking very, very nice. And I went with the kick-ass backspacer in black. This one's a little bit pointier. I mean, you barely see them, they pop out just enough to catch your finger. So it gives a nice traction there on the back. It's good stuff. Love this reptilian pattern, looks real good on here. But this thing is nice and centered. I don't know, occasionally put extra space there for the lock bar. Seems to function better after when you do that. I love the way the light reflects off that reptilian pattern. I also want to thank Infidel X Strong for making that tough toad video. I really like seeing them, guys. I'm really happy that you know, they're out there and people are enjoying them. It's just pretty much a big thing for me, so I get like all giddy when I see someone makes a video. Even with just my pimp work, I just love seeing it. It's just really cool to see reactions and stuff. So next up, this is a long-awaited knife. This has gone through some BS and back. This is a Manix 2 for a Mark. I believe it's a Mark, or Mike, I'm sorry, Mike. And this one went from, you know, it was the first one I did with the different colors, the chameleon looking thing, and then I did these, but they didn't really work out too well. If anybody wants these, I'll sell them to be really cheap, because there's nothing wrong with them. They're just, you know, it's a thin layer of jade. I gotta take it off and refinish that, and, you know, after that they'll be good, but I just wasn't happy with these. And I wanted to do something really cool with it, and I always wanted to do smooth handle on a Manix because it's just so ergonomic already. So I decided to go with the green and blue G10, which is a newer color. Nice and contoured. Feels amazing. I mean, there's a reason there's a screw right there, countersunk. So I put a backspacer in jade. Which looks really sweet. And I think it goes real well with this whole color scheme. But this thing is just so damn comfortable. Like, the bolstered thing on the Manixes is kind of a pain in the ass because you got all these screws up here, you know, but then you got nothing down here. So you have some problems there sometimes. So I figured I'd just quit trying to do that on this guy and just make a nice solid piece that just is really clean. It feels really nice. But that backspacer looks cool as hell on there. I figured, you know, this thing does not have enough jimping, so I just figured I'd add some more, because it's just like, you know, this thing is just basically smooth as a baby's butt all around. Just kidding. But, yeah. But I didn't make it come out too hard. I just, more looks here. You know, it looks really sweet. Really like this color. And I've yet a toxic green and black reptilian. It's on its way back. Pink and black Spartan on its way back. Something else. Oh, George, your zero tolerance is on its way back. Also got some other stuff going out tomorrow. But I do have a lot of openings for, or, you know, I'm still taking orders for the tough toads. They're all going to have those backspacers on them now. I think I like those a lot. So for the second run, you're going to get backspacers that look real sweet. And some of them will be popping out like this one a little bit. You know, like popping out more. Like I don't like the benchmades, but some of them will be like inside like the one I showed before. But they're going to be sweet as hell. And also news on the D2 fixed blades. They are almost done. I just have to, you know, they're, for the most part, ground. They're at my buddy Anonymous's house because I still don't have my grinder. I'm starting to think that's never going to happen. It is paid for, guys, so it's just taking a while to get built. It's a very long process. It's not just buying one. We're actually building them from scratch, so it's going to be pretty damn sweet when they're done. But, yeah, the D2 fixed blades are pretty much, like, ground. They're just rough right now. They just need to be heat treated. So I give it 2 weeks. I'm gonna hope and pray 2 weeks, hopefully, if everything goes right. So after that, you know, these are gonna be really, really sick. They're actually thicker than the one I showed, so it's pretty kick-ass. And I'm gonna do my best to try to find a way to etch logos onto the blades, because I just feel like these things just need it. It's got such a huge blade area. I don't have one here right now. I miss it. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. And you know, if you're interested in the Snowdy knives, contact me. I really like to keep one of them, but I just want to sell. I want to sell one of them, so just so I can get enough to get the Direware, which is I've been trying to get forever. So I just need to sell one of those Snowdies. But you know, thanks for watching, guys, and have a great new year. Peace.